Welcome back to Zoe and Sassafras, Monsters and Mold by Asia Citro, pictured by Marion Lindsay. We are on Chapter 9, The Moldy Fur Experiment. I grabbed my bags of monster fur in my science notebook and went into the kitchen. I started writing down all the bits of my experiment so I wouldn't forget what I'd done. It'd probably take a day or two before I could even tell if the mold wasn't growing on some of my test fur. Could definitely forget a lot in 2 days. Question: what will stop the mold from growing on Gorp's fur? Now I needed to make my guess. Which preservative did I think would work? Most of the stuff in the kitchen used salt. Seemed to work for an awful lot of things, so it would probably work on monster fur too. Hypothesis: I think salt will stop the mold from growing on Gorp's fur. Alright, now to decide how much of each preservative to add. I needed to add the same amount each time. Let's see, maybe 2 teaspoons would be enough? That seemed good to me. Procedure 1. Put the same amount of Gorp's fur in each Ziploc bag. 2. Don't add anything to one bag. Add 2 teaspoons of oil to another. Add 2 teaspoons of vinegar to another. Add 2 teaspoons of salt to another. And add 2 teaspoons of sugar to another. 3. Seal the bags. 4. Put the bags in the same place in the barn and check every day to see if mold grows. Phew, that was a lot of writing. I shook out my hand. First, I sealed the bag with nothing but fur in it. I labeled it so I could remember that it was the one where I didn't add anything. The nothing bag should grow mold like normal. In a few days, I could hold it next to the other bags to see if they were doing a better job of stopping the mold. I got a new bag and added 2 teaspoons of vinegar and swished it around until all of the monster fur in the bag was wet. Crinkled up my nose. Blech. Quickly sealed the bag so I wouldn't have to smell it anymore. I labeled it vinegar. I did the same thing for the oil bag. Things were going just fine until I added sugar to the 4th bag. Urgh. This isn't working, Sassafras. The sugar keeps falling to the bottom of the bag. Most of it isn't even touching the fur. Maybe it would be fine? No, it was definitely bugging me that it wasn't coating the fur like the vinegar and oil had. Suddenly, a big ball of fluffy fur was next to me on the kitchen counter. I was about to yell, "Sassafras, off the counter!" when I realized he was bumping his head against the jelly jar. Was weird. Sassafras liked to eat bugs, not jelly. I popped him down off the counter. Maybe he was trying to tell me to put the jelly back in the fridge. I picked up the jar and glanced over the ingredients one last time. Oh, water. I turned around and picked up the can of beans. It had water too. Right, the beans used salt mixed in water and the jelly used sugar mixed in water. Of course. I added 2 teaspoons of water and 2 teaspoons of salt to a little bowl and 2 teaspoons of water and 2 teaspoons of sugar to another little bowl. I stirred them both really well. Then I added 2 teaspoons of the salt water to the salt bag and 2 teaspoons of the sugar water to the sugar bag. This time when I swished the ingredients around, the sugar and salt water coated the monster fur instead of falling to the bottom. In my science journal, I wrote down the change I'd made to the sugar and salt. I clapped my hands together. Perfect. I was ready to move everything to the barn. Just then, my dad walked in. I froze. Mom had told me that Dad couldn't see anything magical. Would these bags look empty to him? He'd probably think this was the weirdest experiment ever. Dad walked over and ruffled my hair. Experimenting again, Zoe? What's this one about? He glanced over my journal notes. Monster fur? That's a cute idea. Are you running a pretend experiment? He lifted up a bag to the light. Might make it more fun if you had some actual fur in there. Maybe Sassafras could donate some. Sassafras growled. I laughed. The bags did look empty to my dad. That's a great idea, Dad. Thanks, I chirped. After my dad left, I leaned down and whispered to Sassafras, "Don't worry, you can keep your fur." Then I gathered up all of my supplies and headed out to the barn. As I laid everything on the barn desk, I thought of poor Gorp's tears. If the things I was trying didn't stop the mold from growing on his fur, there wouldn't be enough time to run another experiment before the monster ball. Gorp was still moldy. He'd stay home from the dance. Again, my heart dropped. He had to go. This experiment had to work. Chapter 10. Success? It was hard to wait, but mold needs time to grow. So Sassafras and I did our best to stay busy over the next 2 days. We went for walks in the forest with my mom. We hunted for bugs. I built cat-sized forest houses for Sassafras using sticks and giant leaves. Finally, we couldn't distract ourselves anymore. I grabbed my science notebook and ran out to the barn to see how the experiment was going. The first bag I checked was the bag with nothing added. There was definitely mold everywhere. Next, I looked at the oil bag. There was some mold, but not as much as in the nothing bag. So oil had worked a little bit. Then I looked at the salt, vinegar, and sugar bags. I squealed so loudly that Sassafras jumped into the air with all his fur puffed out. I dropped my science notebook and grabbed Sassafras and twirled him around. It worked, Sassafras, it worked. Salt and vinegar and sugar all worked. Right then, the barn doorbell rang. Perfect timing. I ran to the door and flung it open. I was so excited. I hugged Gorp before I even said hello. It worked. I know what to do, I cheered. Gorp's eyes got huge. It worked. He was so happy. He didn't even notice Sassafras purring and weaving around his legs. I grabbed Gorp's arm and pulled him into the barn. Look, we have three choices. Salt, sugar, and vinegar. I held up the bag. A smile lit up Gorp's face. Which should we choose? Good question. You have an awful lot of fur. Let me run in the house and see what we have the most of. I was halfway out the door when I heard a scuffling noise behind me. I turned around to see Gorp backing into a corner of the barn with a terrified look on his face. I guess he'd finally noticed the purring Sassafras at his feet. I scooped up my cat and ran into the house. We'll stop there for today. Up next will be Chapter 11, Decisions, Decisions. We'll find out what Gorp and Zoe decide to try on his fur.